paid that is owed to them, and then the county kind of carries the debt or the liability on its books until all of the tax revenues are collected, including penalty fees, or possibly if even getting to the point of selling the property to recoup those fees. 1992 is when it was begun, and the initial purchase, because you have to start out by initially purchasing that liability, was about $5.5 million. The liability is now about $9 million due to using revenues for operating expenses, as opposed to using it to pay off that liability, and also due to escalating interest on the debt. So that's another place where interest shows up. If you don't pay the debt down, then the interest kind of keeps ratcheting it up. So the agreement is we've got to deal with it. If all of the revenues had been applied against the liabilities, it actually breaks even and does make money for the county. But when the funding is siphoned off for operating expenses, then when you add in the interest on the debt, it doesn't work. So the sooner we can get this evened out, the better. The way I think about it is we're essentially paying on a loan that the county made to itself. And my guess is, I think when we were looking, it was about 10 years ago, 8 to 10 years ago, that much of the borrowing occurred. So that's the explanation. So refining the Teeter plan, the board gave some very specific direction to create a separate budget unit, and we have, it's budget unit 1930, to apply Teeter revenues to the debt rather than placing it in the general fund. So we need to admit up front that part of the challenge in this year's budget is that about $2 to $3 million of revenues that would have gone into the general fund and would have been budgeted there has been redirected towards paying off this debt, which is where it needed to go. Timing, though, you know, it's definitely a hard year to do it, and we're mindful of that. And then we'll revise the amortization schedule for 2009-10 as well. But we are following through on board.
Just a point for the public here. One point for the Teeter plan, though, it's not like the County of Mendocino owes some bank $9 million. It's within the county system. It's kind of like, in a way, you're borrowing money out of your checking account. Or borrowing money.
It's Americans with Disability Act implementation. There is a plan of remediation that the county has, and it's being funded at $100,000 a year to complete that plan. The finance system, as I said before, this is the last year. So after that, we will be out of paying for the finance system. We will also be out of, you know, implementation. Obviously, it will need to be maintained. There will be changes, but it will be basically done. Mill Creek Dams is the amount of money that's estimated will be needed for activities in this next year. So it's not really a debt, but it is a liability because it's something that has a strong impetus that we need to pay it and stay on top of it.
Well, it is an obligation.
So mental health here, this was something that's about the cost of the jail services that mental health provides to the jail. And again, that's not something that mental health funding covers. And so it's here listed as a liability. It has not been necessarily fully funded in the past. So that's something that needs to be looked at. Pension obligation bonds, I have to do with, real quickly, kind of refinancing on the retirement system. And then the underfunded pension obligation bond debt is where, for some reason, 5-6 years ago, there is a specific budget that the pension obligation bonds are paid out of, and for some reason, not enough money was collected from the departments to fully meet the pension obligation bond payments. But you have to make the payments, so those payments were made, and essentially that that left a debt or a hole in the county's budget that the money from the department's contributions goes into. So that should be paid off in this year.
08 or 09.
So this is the last year I'm paying that. So we will wipe two things off of our list, which is good. The Teeter plan, normally the payments are about 2.5 million on the amortization schedule. This reflects putting the revenues towards it as well, and that puts it at $5.1 million. And that's a pretty hefty amount. And then the microwave system, the payment is around $285,000 for this year. So out of this year's budget, approximately $13 million is going towards these debts and liabilities.
Allison.
Yes.
Supervisor Smith.
Yes, Allison, do you have on the chart, is it in one of these figures, the additional amount that is not the 90% payment on the pension obligation bonds, but the additional 10% that the board made the commitment to begin, the 1% annual repayment initiated this fiscal year?
No, I don't have it on any of the charts here. Where